watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
Hi, this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Welcome, 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 welcome. Can you believe it? Well, in a few short weeks from now, it will be the middle of the year. It'll be the middle of the year. It'll be half of 2011. And my question to you today on the broadcast is, where are you? Yes, that's my question to you. Where are you? You're probably wondering, what's she talking about? I'm at home, you know, I'm at work, or wherever you're watching the show from. But that's not what I mean. My question to you is, where are you vis-a-vis in comparison to the goals and the dreams and the visions that you set for yourself at the beginning of the year? And so today on the broadcast, together, we're going to pause and we're going to reflect and we are going to recapture. Yes, that's what we're going to be doing tonight together on the show. So I want you to go get your notepad and get ready to pause, to reflect, and to recapture. And what I mean by recapture is that I want us together on today's show to be able to recapture your enthusiasm, your zeal, the passion that you had for your dreams and your visions and your goals at the beginning of the year. You know what I've found? That most people start the beginning of the year very enthusiastic. You know, the new year, we're also excited. You know, we make all kinds of resolutions, whether it's personal, whether it's professional, whether it's spiritual. Some people say, you know what, I'm going to lose 20 pounds this year. You know, some other people, you know, who are spiritual will say, you know, I'm going to move closer to God. I'm going to pray more. I'm going to fast more. I'm going to spend more time in the Word. You know, others, you know, will set certain goals for themselves professionally and say, hey, you know what, I'm going to, you know, have so many contracts. I'm going to get a promotion. I'm going to transition into a new job. Others set all kinds of financial goals, you know. I'm going to make so much money this year. I'm going to travel. I'm going to go on vacation. It doesn't matter, you know, just different kind of things that we kind of set at the beginning of the year, all kinds of resolutions. And then we get really very excited. We're very motivated, you know. We're going to the gym. We're networking. And then, you know, the days turn into weeks and the weeks into months, and then, you know, it's like our enthusiasm begins to wane, and then we become distracted, and then, you know, we lose focus, and, you know, and then we suddenly find ourselves at the middle of the year, and before we know it, the year ends, and then we're no closer to our dreams than we were at the beginning. And then, you know, that vicious circle just keeps continuing and continuing. And before long, before you know it, hey, maybe you're 80, 90, 100, and you've never really fulfilled or reached, you know, one of your life's dream. And so, you know, one practice, one habit that I find that really helps me personally to really kind of stay motivated and stay focused and really ensures that, you know, I really reach my dreams and the goals that I set for me each year is this habit of mine of always pausing. okay, of always just pausing, of always reflecting, and just taking time out of my busy schedule to evaluate, you know, to measure, to take stock of where I am, and then, you know, try and, you know, recapture my enthusiasm, try and refocus, you know, I eliminate all the distractions and the cares of life, things that come my way that I find are beginning to crowd my vision, you know, and then I re-strategize, you know, I measure, like I said, I say, you know, where am I, what am I trying to accomplish, what's working, what's not working, you know, and then I re-strategize, and, you know, I find that, you know, doing that practice, having that regular time of retreat, and that regular time of pause really helps me, and I find at the end of the year that I'm focused and that I've really been able to accomplish a lot of the things that I've set up, you know, set my mind to do at the beginning of a year. So that's what we're doing today, mid-year reflection. And, you know, by popular demand, I've even taken this mid-year reflection and I'm doing it as a live workshop. As a live workshop, I call it power retreats, okay? And whereby, you know, I'm getting a group of, you know, few people, just a small group of people together to retreat with me and spend 1, 2, 3 hours together where we are reflecting, where we are recapturing, where we are refocusing, and where we are re-strategizing. And that power retreat will take place on Wednesday, May 18th, right here in the town of West Hartford, Connecticut, at the Chatfield. The Chatfield is located on 1 Chatfield Drive in West Hartford, Connecticut. You can go to my website, www.royalproclamations.com, to learn more. Okay, royalproclamations.com. But that's what we're going to be doing live, and that's what we're going to be doing on the show. So the first thing I want us to do is just pause, okay? So that's the first step towards really kind of recapturing your zeal and your passion and reaching your goals for the end of the year. So pause, write that in your notebook, pause. So just pause, quiet everything around you as much as you can. And then the next thing is reflect, okay? Reflect and just ask yourself these simple questions. Where am I? Where am I? Where am I? Where am I? You know, okay, you wanted to lose 20 pounds, for example. Where am I? Have I lost 2 pounds at all? Have I lost 3 pounds? You know, where am I compared to that goal? Or, you know, whatever it is, you know, just reflect and evaluate and measure. How far have I gotten, you know? And then, you know, you want to then also say, what way can I recapture that enthusiasm? And one way of doing it is by going back to the drawing board, your mission, you know, getting back your mission. Why am I even wanting to do this? You know, why do I want to lose weight? Is it because I want to live healthier? I want to be healthier? You know, why do I want that business deal? Why do I want that promotion? Go back to your why. Go back to your mission. And you'll find that as you revisit the drawing book and go back to your mission statement, you find yourself motivated. You recapture that zeal and enthusiasm. And then the next step is to refocus. Refocus, yes. You see, so we've got the hours going on. Okay, so if you remember all those 4 hours, you'll be on your way. And don't forget that you can join my workshop. You know, you can be part of this mastermind group of, you know, like-minded people, and sign up for this power retreat on Wednesday, May 18th at the Chatfield. Go to my website, royalproclamations.com, because then, you know, you will not only be getting all the tips and the tools and the strategies, but you also be synergizing and networking with like-minded people, you know, and together, you know, we're iron sharpening iron. We can really together kind of keep ourselves accountable and motivated. So that's the first hour. The first hour is to reflect. Where am I, you know, vis-a-vis my goals and dreams? How close am I to them? What have I accomplished? The next thing is you want to then recapture, you know, another hour. You want to recapture that enthusiasm that is beginning to wane. You want to recapture it by going back to the drawing board, going back to your mission and vision, the reason why you're in business, the reason why you want to do these things. You go back to the why, you know, and you find that once you can get back to the why, get to the root of why you really, really want to achieve whatever it is you set out to achieve, you know, be it travel, be it personal, whatever it is, then the motivation comes back, you know. And so you recapture, and then in the next hour is you refocus. And in order to refocus, you have to identify, okay? You have to identify the blocks, the obstacles, the hindrances, the things that have crept into your life and that are kind of like helping, you know, causing you to lose vision and causing you to be distracted. So identify those obstacles. I'll give myself as a personal example because I practice what I preach, okay? And I, at the beginning of the year, you know, I set my heart on two things. Number one, that I was going to equip my clients with a new program that I called The Power Bridges to Destiny. And that I was also going to capture all that information in a book. Okay, so I was going to write a book. And this book and the program would, you know, was to equip people and educate people and inspire people and give them the tools and the strategies and the principles of how they can get from A to B, how they can reach their goals and their dreams, you know. And, you know, I really started off the year really kind of really enthusiastic, you know. There are six power bridges that everyone must build. And so if you remember, we started the year talking about the money bridge and building the money bridge and then the people bridge. And I brought in experts and guests who talk about, you know, how to financial success and networking. And don't forget that all the videos are available for you on demand. So inspiration on demand on my website, royalproclamations.com, or you can go to whctv.org, you know, to look that up, those videos, if you miss them or you just want to review them again to recollect. You know, so I kind of really started, I was staying focused, I was on course, I was staying the course and everything. And then, you know, I got distracted, I was planning a conference and, you know, before long I found that, wow, Valau, you know, where am I, you know, and so on and so forth. So you have to be able to identify the distractions. And for me, I was able to identify some of the distractions as being, you know, some of the event planning that I was doing and so on and so forth. So identify the distractions and eliminate them. Of course, you got to eliminate them in order for you to refocus. Okay, so we've looked at three principles, three steps so far. Number one is an R, you reflect. Number two is another R, you recapture. And number three is refocus. And don't forget that on Inspire Success Today, we are, you know, it's a mid-year reflection because, you know, I don't want another year to bite the dust. I don't know, before long, it'll be the end of 2011. Time flies so quickly, you know. Before long, it'll be the end of the year. And then you're going to be saying to yourself, oh my goodness, you know, oh, another failed dreams, another year has gone by, blah, 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 you know. But, you know, we can pause, you know. And isn't it amazing how sometimes we as individuals, we race through life without really pausing. But then look at all most equipments that are out there, you know, whether it's your VCR, whether, you know, it's a laptop, whether, you know, it's your television, whether, you know, it's your car, there is a pause button on them. There is a pause button. There's a mute button. There's a neutral button. And, you know, those things are there for equipment so that you give them a season or just a period, no matter how brief, of rest, a period where they can just be mute, be quiet, and, you know, function better, and you can, and fine-tune and so on and so forth. And we need to have this practice as well as humans, you know. We need to pause. We just need to take time out of our busy schedule and, you know, step back and reflect. And then, like I said, you reflect, you recapture, you refocus, you eliminate everything that's distracting you, anything that doesn't further your mission, you know, anyone that doesn't further your mission, you eliminate, you know, you eliminate, and you kind of, you know, it will help you to kind of stay focused on your goal, on your vision, and then you know you re-strategize. That's the next R. You re-strategize, and you know, I know this is a short broadcast, and there's no way that I can give you all the step by step in detail, which is why I'm putting together this live event on May 18th. So mark your calendar. It's a Wednesday night from about 6 to 9, just 3 hours, 180 minutes for you to retreat and reflect and recapture and refocus and re-strategize. And, you know, it's a mastermind group of very like-minded individuals. There's a small group, you know, no more, max, no more than 30 people, you know, just coming together and really making sure we're staying the course and we're accountable to each other. And, you know, this is for people who mean business, people who are serious about their destiny, about their dreams, about their goals, not people who pay lip service to it. So you can learn more and go to my website, royalproclamations.com, to register. But like I said, the next R will be you re-strategize, okay? And in order to re-strategize, you have to really then look at, you know, what's working, what's not working, you know, where am I trying to accomplish, you know, what is working, what's not working, you know? I mean, you know, I think it was Henry Ford who said, you know, only a fool does the same thing over and over and expect different results. And I know you're no fool, you know? And, you know, so you look at what's working, what's not working. You know, for example, you're trying to, you know, write a book, you're trying to find a new career and all of that. You know, where are you networking? Where are you applying and all of that? Are you doing it online? Where are you doing the job search? Is it Craigslist? Is it career builders? If you've been searching those kind of places and it's not working, you're not getting the results, you're not any closer, you're not getting interviews or whatever, why are you still using that strategy? Maybe you want to, you change your strategy, you know, and you want to try something different, you know, and you want to do more face-to-face and so on and so forth. So really based on what your goals are and your objectives are, you may need to re-strategize. It's the middle of the year. It's June already. In a few weeks, it'll be June. It's May now, but in a few weeks, it'll be June. And so you want to say to yourself, what's working, what's not working, you know. And you may need to also, you know, get professional help. And this is what I always try and make us understand that, you know, sometimes you need to, you know, work with, you know, like-minded people, with coaches and people like that who can help you to plan and strategize, you know, get a strategic partner. You know, that's what your coach is, your business coach is. It'll be my honor to help you, you know, because if you fail to plan, you do what? You plan to fail. So you then re-strategize, you come up with a concrete plan with measurable steps, you know, and you know, hopefully then, you know, you now start implementing that to help you to reach your goals. My mission, my desire for you, my commitment to you is to help you to make sure that you reach those goals. Don't forget, I'm America's dream midwife and destiny coach. And that is the reason why I exist. That's the reason why my company exists, to equip people with the knowledge, with the power, the motivations, and the skills to really help them realize their potential, pursue their passions, live their dreams, achieve greater financial success, make, you know, build relationships, and just excel at work and in life. So I'm committed to your success. And, you know, if you're just tuning in, we're talking today on Inspired Success. It's our Midyear reflection. We're talking about pause. We're talking about reflect and recapture and refocus and re-strategize. We're just talking about really taking time out of your busy schedule as the year is slowly but surely, before we know it, coming to an end. And then where would you be? Where are you? you know, would it be yet another year? And then you now start looking forward to 2012 and you'll be like, okay, you're enthusiastic again. And it's just a vicious circle for many. You know, you're enthusiastic, a new year comes, you're motivated, you make all those resolutions, you sign up, you get a coach, you're doing everything right. And then slowly the days into weeks, into months, and you know, your enthusiasm wanes and all kinds of distractions begin to crowd your vision, and you know, then another year ends, you know, but this year is going to be different for you. This year will be different for you. I want you to say that to yourself, that this year will be different for me. You know, make that affirmation. This year is going to be different. This year for real, it's going to be for real. I am going to achieve everything I set my heart to do. And you have the power within you to do it. And one of the strategies and the ways to do it is what I'm sharing with you, and it's what I'm going to be sharing with you even in a deeper way, you know, at my workshop on May 18th, royalproclamations.com. You know, I'm really kind of going to go in together. We're going to go in, and we're going to be surrounded by like-minded people who mean business. I'm not talking about, you know, some of us are not just so real, we, you know, about our destinies. We just pay lip service. We are not willing to pay the price, and there is a price to pay. And, you know, so today I'm just saying, you know, pause, take that time, you know, just stop racing through life, you know. Life's too fragile, life's too important, your destiny is too important for you to just race through it, you know. And so pause and be a part of that three-hour retreat, and I'm sure you're writing, and we've talked about those four principles, those four strategies. Number one, as we recap, number one is you want to do what? You want to reflect. You want to reflect, where am I? That's where I opened up the broadcast. Where am I? Where are you? Vis-a-vis your goals and your dreams. Where am I? And so you want to really take stock. You want to evaluate. You want to measure. Okay, where am I? You know, how far have I gotten? You know, how far have I come? You know, so, you know, like I gave initially in my example, he said one of your goals, which I know a lot of us want to lose weight. You know, you know, have I lost 2 pounds out of 20? Or, you know, some of us, you know, you want to meet your life partner. You said, this is the year. I must meet Mr. Wright or Mrs. Wright. And, you know, am I dating? You know, where are you? Am I at least dating, or am I meeting people? And so on and so forth. So that's the first thing. Reflect. You pause, you reflect. The next R is you try and recapture. Recapture that zeal, that enthusiasm, that passion, you know, that you had at the beginning of the year. Recapture your motivation. And how do you do it? By going back to the drawing board, going back to your mission statement and saying, hey, this is the why. Getting back to the why of why, the why of why. You know, it's a huge question. Why do I want to lose weight? Why do I want to be married? When you get to the why, to the root reason why you want to achieve those goals, you know, and you can get to the nobility of that why, you know, and you will get motivated. You would recapture your zeal. And then the next R, like I said, is to refocus. And I said you need to identify all the distractions and eliminate them. Identify them and eliminate them. You know, sometimes people are distractions. Do you know that? People are distractions. So, you know, not everybody needs to be in your network. Not everybody needs to be around you, and you don't need to be around everybody. Some people are just, you know what I'm saying? You know, they would discourage you, they would distract you, and so on and so forth. So, you know, if it's people, just press that delete button. Delete, you know, you gotta go. And if it's an event, if it's something you're doing that doesn't further your mission, delete. You know, get rid of the distractions so that you sharpen your vision and your focus back on your goal. And then, you know, the next R is re-strategize. You know, why are you using something that's not working? You know, if you've evaluated it, you've used this platform, you've used this strategy, you re-strategize, you work with a professional, you know, come up with a concrete plan. you know, with measuring, boost steps, change your strategies. Don't keep doing the same thing over and over. If it's the middle of the year almost and it's not working, then, hey, you know what I'm saying? You know, change strategy. And, you know, before long, you'll be back. You'll be there. You will be there. And I'm declaring that to you. And I'm saying you will be there. You have everything it takes. Just stay on course. Stay focused. Sign up for, you know, the Inspired Success Power Retreats. I'm going to be doing a couple of them, short retreats for now. And I'm going to give you the opportunity of joining me because this is one of my habits. You know, those who know me, those who are in my inner circle, they know that this is something I just do. I live by it. This is one of the major habits and practices of my effectiveness and of my success. I just do it regularly, take time to retreat, regularly take time to evaluate. I'm constantly evaluating, reflecting, measuring where I am, making sure that I'm on course. And you'll have that opportunity to join me. You have that opportunity to join like-minded people. Again, remember, it's Wednesday, May 18th. It's right here in the town of West Hartford, Connecticut. You know, it's in the state of Connecticut. And so, you know, hey, drive down, register online, royalproclamations.com. You know, for the sake of my out-of-state viewers, because many people watch Inspired Success online, and you are in Chicago, you're even in Malaysia, or whatever, you know, in the world you're watching, I'm really thinking about it over the summer to do a power retreat webinar. So that will give the opportunity to others to be able to kind of participate and join with me, where we kind of go in a little bit more detail. So it's so exciting, I really hope that you've taken down this information and that you will practice it. You'll put it into practice and you will take time mid-year, you know, to pause. You will take time to reflect. You will take time to recapture. And I really, truly just wish you all life success. I wish you to your dreams, your goals, and your dreams will become a reality this year. And, you know, I'm rooting for you. You know that. And I'm your partner in total success. And if you can travel, you can come for this live workshop. You know, hey, be a part of it. Let's do it together. And, you know, let's make sure that 2011 is the year of fulfilled dreams. It's a year of fulfilled dreams, of accomplishment, and of fulfillment and manifestation. You know, and, you know, this is, you know, of course, you know, Princess Bola Adelani, the total success coach, just reminding you to keep smiling. Put a smile on your face. Hey, life's too short. A smile of your face. Keep learning, you know, keep learning, keep believing, keep networking, and keep on keeping on. Don't forget that you can find me on Facebook, all the social media websites. I'm there. I'm on Facebook. I'm on Twitter. You can follow me on Twitter, and I'm LinkedIn as well. Just search for Princess Bola Adelani, you know, and of course, my website is royalproclamations.com. Come, and you know, I look forward to seeing you at my live workshop. I look forward to seeing you on the show next month. Next month, you know, it's Father's Day month. It'll be June, and I'll be bringing in, as usual, a diverse panel of men. You know, I'm dedicating it, as usual, to men, to fathers, to brothers, and I'm bringing in a diverse panel of men, and we're going to be talking about what makes men tick. And not so tick, you know. And so that should be an exciting show. So be on the lookout for that. Again, you know, keep smiling, keep believing. I look forward to seeing you soon and rooting for your success. Okay? Stay blessed. Thank you for tuning in. Bye-bye.